to see you later. Gotta hit the road, gotta hit the road. The sun ain't changing the atmosphere. Architecture unfamiliar. I could get used to this. Time flies by in the yellow and green. Stick around and you'll see what I mean. There's a mountain top that I'm dreaming of. If you need me, you know where I'll be. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. We're south of the equator, navigating.
Good morning, good morning. Students, we are about to start. Please take your seats and make sure you have your coats prepped. Students, please take your seats and make sure you have your coats prepped for the ceremony.
I'm dreaming of. If you need me, you know where I'll be. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a
soul to every Check, check. Hello, everybody. Greetings. Welcome. My name is Wolfgang Goodyear. I am the Executive Student Body President, but more than that, I'm a fellow student, Tri-8, so I was just in this position last try. Welcome to the White Coat Ceremony. Before we get started, I want to give some acknowledgments. And please hold your applause, because I really want to give a big round of applause to the staff right afterwards. But first, we have Dr. William E. Morgan, the president of Parker University. Woo-woo! We have Dr. Jay Michelle, EVP and provost. We have Dean Elena Mount, associate provost and dean of students. We have Dr. Patrick Bodner? Okay, he's here, all right. And then we have Miss Lisa Gabriel, and we have Dr. Leon Tom, Dr. Celia McGuire, and we have Dr. Gordon Newell, Assistant Dean of Student Affairs. And as student body president, I get to see behind the scenes, behind the veil, and I get to see how hard the staff works and how much they really care. And so I just want to give a big bow and a huge bow of gratitude and love to all the staff and to the CFDs. Thank you so much. Give a big round of applause. And now there's somebody else in the room that I want to acknowledge. You know, as students, it has been really hard for us these past 2.5 years. We have been through a lot and we have sacrificed a lot, but there's been somebody else that has sacrificed a lot for us. Maybe it is your spouse, maybe it is your parents, your siblings, but it is your loved ones that have also sacrificed a lot. So I just want to give a huge round of applause to all of those who have come in support. Thank you so much. I know personally that I may have missed a few holidays, or maybe I couldn't attend all the family events that I wanted to attend, or maybe I just wasn't emotionally available for my family and for the ones that are close to me. And I know that that has come at a sacrifice. So just a huge bow and huge amount of gratitude. Thank you so much. And now I want to acknowledge the students. It's been a rough 2.5 years. You have gotten through it and you have become a family. And that is one thing that really separates us, I think, from other medical schools, is that we get, as chiropractors, we get to link arms. We become close. And we need this. We need to become family. And I want to encourage you to continue to become family and to continue to become closer as we move into this next stage, into clinic. As chiropractors, we understand that healing happens. The developer of chiropractic says healing happens from above down, inside out. That's BJ Palmer. And we, as practicing clinicians, get to use evidence-based approach to serve our patients. And it's just an honor to serve. Our founding father, Dr. Jim Parker, says that loving service is our first technique. And that's why I became a chiropractor, to be in loving service. But how do we show up in loving service? Above, down, inside out, we connect to the thing that is above. Again, James Parker, our school founder, says, he calls it infinite oneness. We can call it God, Allah, Krishna. But we connect to that which is, that makes the body, that which heals the body. We connect to that. Inside out, we connect to our why. If you can connect to your why and why you're going over there, why you became a chiropractor, then you can overcome anything. You can overcome any obstacle. And I also want to say that when we are over there as clinicians, what does it mean to be a clinician? What does it mean to be a doctor? It means to take radical responsibility for our patients, for all that they come in. We have to take radical responsibility. We have to do the research. We have to be 100% all in so that we can show up. We have to be up to date on the science, up to date on the literature, so that we can show up and be the best clinicians ever. And so I want to encourage you all to continue to recommit. Use this ceremony to recommit, because it's been a 2.5 years you've got here, but put some more wood on the fire and get excited, because you get to serve. This is what you are here for, and give it your all this last year. Grow, grow, grow. And I will end with this. Dr. James Parker, he made our school logo the flame. What is this flame? This flame is the chiropractic torch that gets to be passed on. It's a chiropractic torch that got from our founder, D.D. Palmer, to B.J. Palmer, to Clarence Gonstead, Clay Thompson, to our president, to our faculty, to the CFDs, our clinic faculty doctors. They are passing on the torch of chiropractic, the Parker flame, onto us so that we can go and serve. This is a wonderful profession. And I encourage all of those in the audience, if you're looking for a profession, this is the one. We need chiropractors. We need people to fight the good fight for righteous healthcare, holistic health and healing, evidence-based approach from the inside out. We can do this. May we love, may we serve, may we give, may we remember our why. Congratulations, Tri-7. You made it to the next step. I'd like to now welcome to the stage Dr. William Morgan, president of Parker University.
Thank you, Wolfgang. Well, guests, and of course our students, it's a very important day. We like to make a ceremony of this too, because for many of us, it's 7 years of marching and learning and understanding the basic sciences and the clinical sciences, but we want to make a ceremony to commemorate. This is the day you take up that symbolic mantle, the white coat, and you're going to see patients, and they're going to be trusting you with their care. I sat in your spot 39 years ago, and I remember it as we took that on, and we want you to soberly reflect and take this day to remember this is a big change. This is not sitting in a classroom absorbing. This is applying knowledge you've spent these many years acquiring. And you need to trust your clinicians who will be your mentors, who you remember the rest of your life. And I would share that you would embrace HHI, humanity. The reason you're here is to serve humanity. Humanity that realizes that health doesn't come out of a pill bottle. And for those who don't understand chiropractic, our basic premise is we're here to remove the barrier to good health so the body can heal itself. Your body almost always can heal itself if you allow it to, if you remove the barriers to good health. They need a chiropractic adjustment, nutrition, exercise, lifestyle choices, the things that you've been trained to administer, humanity. And then humility, to be humble enough to go to a master and have them, I'm having a hard time with this adjustment, or I don't quite understand what's going on with this patient. Be humble enough to ask for care, because in a couple of years, you're going to be on your own. Make the most of the opportunity to have masters in the craft who are here to mentor you and to grow in your clinical skills. And the I is integrity. Always protect your integrity. There's nothing more valuable in your life than maintaining your integrity. We're here to make sure that you're prepared for those patients. The world is waiting for you. They need you. But as I said earlier, the white coat is a symbol. But we really want you to lay behind. Remember, those years in the classroom are behind. You're now going ahead, and you're going to be putting your hands on people. And people for the rest of your life are going to be trusting you that you were kept abreast of the evidence, and you're current, and that you are going to provide them the best possible care. So it's been great to see you in your journey. I look forward to next year calling you doctors and being the first person to call you doctor as you graduate. Well, blessings to you all. And I think we're going to bring Wolfgang back to the podium.
It is now my privilege to welcome Dr. Jane Michella, Executive Vice President and Provost of Parker University.
Thank you, Wolfgang. Thank you, President Morgan. I'd like to echo some things that Wolfgang said earlier, and that's to acknowledge how you all have gotten here so far. There's a lot of work you did, but there's a lot of support you've gotten. So if you're able, students, please stand, face your audience. And our VIPs here today are the parents, siblings, grandparents, aunts, uncles, children, friends, and supporters of our students. We also have, I see in the audience, staff and faculty. Stand up and be recognized. Students, thank them. Thank you. You are the support these students needed to get this far. They need you more than ever to support them through these last trimesters towards graduation. Thank you for all you do for these students. White coats are worn by both doctors and doctoral students and have a proud history. White coats are symbols of healing for healthcare professionals and help build trust in the doctor-patient relationship, as Dr. Morgan said. White coat ceremonies are a rite of passage at most healthcare doctoral programs. The coat serves as a visual representation of the immense responsibility entrusted to these future physicians. They are required to promote a professional look, and don't they look beautiful? If you look around the campus, you'll see a lot of our students and faculty wearing these white coats, and they look great. For the student, the white coat ceremony marks a personal transition from student to caregiver. Congratulations, you're well on your way to becoming the doctor you have dreamed of becoming. Thank you.
I'd like to now welcome Dr. Celia McGuire, Dean of Academics for the College of Chiropractic.
Thank you, Wolfgang. You know, the white coat ceremony is so special because it symbolizes that transition between academics and clinics. And I know the first time I put on that white coat and I looked in the mirror, I really had conflicted feelings. So on one hand, I had this imposter syndrome where you put on the white coat and you think to yourself, I'm not worthy. But remember, you know, way back when you were elbow deep in biochemistry, you probably couldn't see what the point of those really, really hard classes was. But then when you got to nutrition, it made a lot more sense. And it's the same thing with physiology and diagnosis classes. We built this program towards your clinical mastery. And so now you've earned that white coat. So wear it with pride. And at the same time, remember, was it Uncle Ben, Spider-Man's uncle, that said, with great privilege comes great responsibility. So I know when I was a student, there were orthopedic tests that we don't do anymore. There are new tests that we didn't even know back then. There are technologies that exist that didn't exist back then. And so it is your responsibility to make sure that you don't stop learning when you walk out of the classroom, that you continue to stay up on new technologies and new methods of treatment and new ways to benefit your patients. And so I'm so proud of you guys. Congratulations for moving on to the next step. And I assure you, graduation is just around the corner. So please savor the time that you spend in clinic. Learn as much as you can from the masters you have here on the stage. And good luck to you all. Congratulations. I would now like to bring to the stage your dean from another scene, the Dean of Clinics, Dr. Leon Tom.
Thank you, Dr. McGuire. You know, this stage means a lot to me. And the reason is 28 years ago, I first came to this country in order to pursue a dream of being a chiropractor. So it was snowing at the time. And as I crossed this big blue body of water, I realized that my life was going to change forever. So as I crossed over Niagara Falls and drove into Dallas, it was just like today, a beautiful, high of low 70s. And my friend and I, who helped drive me down to Dallas, thought it was great to have warm weather. We carried a cooler of beer and went out by the pool. And there was no one else there for some reason. And then fast forward 3 years, and it goes by so quick. So, you know, I encourage you all to really appreciate the time here amongst your friends, because after graduation, you may not ever see this group together at one time ever again. But hopefully you'll be able to do so at a reunion. At Parker Seminars, yes. 25 years ago, I walked this stage again and as a graduate, and took a photo in front of this stage with my dad, who helped finance my entire education, and I was very appreciative of it. It's amazing how time flies, that it's been 25 years. I do want to congratulate you all in reaching the stage. This is the time where you've actually get to put together all the pieces that you've learned from the first seven trimesters. And you really need to practice your art. You want to make sure that you present that certainty to that patient. And even though inside you might feel that you might be going through an imposter syndrome, or you might not feel that your skill level's to a certain level that you'd like it to be, please reach out for assistance and even get your clinic faculty doctor to help provide some of those adjustments for you. I want to make sure that not, you know, everyone that leaves our clinic gets the proper or the highest quality care and gets adjusted. So if you need help doing a boom shakalaka, a side posture adjustment, get one of your docs to definitely help you out. You want to walk into that room with certainty so that that patient has confidence in your abilities. So if you're not in that present time consciousness with your patients, you can make little errors such as putting the cassette into the stand-up bucky for a recumbent view on the x-ray, which doesn't really give that much confidence to a patient. And I tell that story because I've seen it before to one of my classmates. So, you know, speaking about certainty, it reminds me of my first time doing acupuncture in private practice, and a person came in with a knee complaint, and I was going to, and I went outside the room, looked up all the points, kind of play through in my head what I was going to do, and I went back into the room. And I guess it's possible, I looked a lot younger back then, and maybe I was sweating or shaking with a needle, or possibly. And the patient asked, "How long have you been doing this for?" And I just kind of turned to look at him, and I said, "My people have been doing it for thousands of years." And we all laughed. And I put the needles in, and luckily, there was no bleeding or anything like that, because that was going through my head. It's like, oh, what if I put something in, and he starts bleeding? I got to compress it. But, you know, just kind of make sure that you present yourself with your patients with a high level of confidence and certainty. Act the part and look the part. So you might run into certain obstacles throughout your journey through clinics. I want you to know that you have many resources for you to seek. And that could be from student affairs and from our clinic doctors. we're more than happy to make sure that you all finish in the, or at least reach your goal in the time that you intend to. So please reach out if you have any issues. I'm more than happy to help each and every one of you. So best of luck. And please join me in welcoming Dr. Gordon Newell, Assistant Dean of Student Clinics or Student Affairs, for the presentation of the White Coats.
Good morning. Will the clinic faculty please rise to mark this point of the program? And students, at this time, I ask you to stand and proceed to the stage for the presentation of your white coat. This distinction will help to highlight you within the clinic as a future doctor of chiropractic. Coating the first group of students will be Dr. Marquis. The rest of the clinic faculty can have a seat to your call. Mohammed Riza Ahmadi. Jonathan Aquila. Madison Albright. Barrett Batai. Christian Bakta. Rebecca Borderland. Amanda Borderland Ross. Cassidy Brooks. Matthew Brown. Abriana Brush. Madeline Burke. Courtney Bush. Jennifer Collicott. Braden Campbell. Sebastian Childcraft. Delphine Coffin. Kelly Colbert. Emily Connor. Austin Corbett. Christian Corona. Anthony Cruz. Coding the next group of students will be Dr. Spencer. Madison Daniel. Amy DeJunas Sova. Heriberto De Labra. Antonia Dennison. Brandon Diaz. Callie Dorman. Riley Dreher. Ryan Evans. Haley Federer. Bianca Fleury. Raul Franco. Michelle Fries. Karina Galindo. Taylor Glotzbach. Ariane Golestani. Mariah Gray Herndon. Jackson Greenhall. Woo! Rachel Gary. Matthew Gersey. Trace Hamby. Kyle Harders. Coding the next group of students, Dr. Maimon. Reed Harris. Tatum Hart. Eduardo Holgan. Brandon Hewer. Cameron Jelks. April Jimenez. Justin Johnson. Tavian Jones. Michaela Jurgens. Dalton Kinder. Candace Kingsman. Caroline Kirkpatrick. Cody Knight. Olivia Kuderna. Jade Lawler. Sydney Leatherman. Hope Pauline Lockhart. Tyler Mason Lopazer. Andrew Maloke. Kyle Meanweather. Alanis Medina Ventura. Angel Minna. Sarah Mertz. Coding the next group of students, Dr. Peeler. Cody Mielmeyer. Lauren Taylor Millen. Levi Millen. Alec Morales Montoya. Emma Mitchell. Lauren Moore. Wendy Morales. Vanessa Morin. Walter Muir. Adam Nguyen. Damian Nguyen. Kaylee Nolan. Dallin Osborne. McKay Osborne. Michael Osborne. Abby Adlow. Daniel Park. Jonki Patel. Sarah Polanco. Jonathan Preston. Madison Ralston. Jairo Jesus Ramirez. Coding the next group of students, Dr. Newman. Ivan Ramos. Federico Resendez. Wesley Stephen Rogers. Melissa Rubio. Rafael Saavedra. Gabriela Saldivar Ford. Michaelin Sanders. Christian Sanford. Hunter Sater. Larry Schaefer. Susanna Scherer. Miranda Schultz. Shakira Seatruck. Sophia Seaton. Jordan Semedini. Hideel Sharif. Jessica Silva. Emily Simmons. Jasmine Sims. Coding the next group of students, Dr. Raper. Ariana Sergu. Evan Smith. Cullis Stevenson. Quay Stokes. Zachary Sullivan. Gracie Tosetta. Brett Teller. Kayla Thompson. Zachary Allen T. Meyer. Stephanie Unsworth. Michael Velasco. Jenny Walsh. Jacob Williamson. Kobe Wood. Addison Wood. Case Woodard. Ryan Worley. Ashley Wyatt. Alyssa Zuzu Austin. Let's all stand and congratulate our new student interns. I'd like to welcome back to the microphone Wolfgang to close.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you, doctors. Thank you, administration. In closing, I want us to take a moment, and as Dr. Leon Tom mentioned, present time consciousness. Come into this moment. Be thankful. One day, we can sometimes get caught in the, one day I'll be a doctor, one day I'll get accepted into chiropractic student, one day I'll open my own clinic, one day this, one day that. And just, I want to invite all of us to be really present right now. And to be thankful and to be acknowledgement of yourself and of your family and of all the work that it's taken to get here. Please feel free to use the remaining time to take pictures and to socialize and to celebrate. Thank you so much.